So we'll continue with this example number 12. In this, in figure, if AD is perpendicular to BC, AD is perpendicular to BC, prove that AB square plus CD square is equal to BD square plus AC square. Okay. So what is given to us? Given AD is perpendicular to BC. And from this what we can say, triangle ADB and ADC are right angle triangles. So what is required for us to prove? What is required for us to prove? AB square plus CD square is equal to BD square plus AC square. This we need to prove. For that, what I need to write? In triangle ADB, angle ADB is equal to 90 degree. Angle ADB is equal to 90 degree. It is given. Okay. So what can I write then? Therefore, AB square is equal to AB square plus DB square. Fine. We call it as equation number 1. Next, in triangle ADC, angle ADC is equal to 90 degree. So therefore what we can write? We can write AC square is equal to AD square, AC square is equal to C. Right angle, let's see, this is the right angle, opposite to the right angle, in the right angle triangle, that will be hypotenuse, that is hypotenuse square is equal to sum of other two sides square, that is AD square plus CD square. So we'll call it as equation number 2. So what we require is AB square plus CD square. Where is CD square? Here is the CD square. So for that, what we need? See what is common here? AD square is common. Okay. So for AB square we need positive sign. Okay. Equation 1 minus equation 2 will give us equation. I'll write here. Equation 1 minus equation 2 will give us AB square minus AC square is equal to AD square plus DB square, AD square plus DB square minus AD square minus CD square, AD square minus CD square. See, wait, it's visible now. This AD square will get cancelled. Now, AB square minus AC square is equal to BD square, DB or BD? BD square minus CD square. So, what is required for us? AB square. I'll move it to the left hand side. AB square minus will become plus CD square is equal to BD square as it is. Plus, minus will become plus. If you move to the right hand side, then it is equal to AC square. I think this is the required proof. AB square plus CD square is equal to BD square plus AC square. This is the required proof. Please note this one. So, 13th example. BL and CM are medians of a triangle ABC. BL and CM are the medians of a triangle ABC. Right angle at A. It is right angle at A. Prove that 4CBBC square plus CM square is equal to 5AC square. Okay. So we will note down what is given to us. Given, what is given? Since BL is a median, BL and CM are a median, medians, I can write, see, what I can write? I can write CL is equal to AC by 2. Can I write? And even AM is equal to AB by 2. I can write. Because AM plus MB is equal to AB. AM is equal to MB because CM is a median. And even L is a, AL is a median. See, BL and CM are medians. Since BL is a median, CL is equal to AL, or else CL is equal to, or else CL or AL. CL or AL is equal to AC by, CL or AL is equal to AC by 2. In case AM or MB, even BM is also equal to AB by 2, we can write. Okay. Now, what is required for us to prove? And even they are given angle A is equal to 90 degree. Okay. What is required for us to prove? We need to prove 4 times BL square plus CM square is equal to 5 times BC square. Okay. So, why don't I write down the proof now? In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, BC square is equal to, BC square is equal, since angle A is equal to 90 degree, hypotenuse C, opposite to the 90 degree, hypotenuse will be there, BC square is equal to AC square plus AB square. So we will call it as equation number 1. This is because of Pythagoras theorem. Next. In triangle AMC. In triangle ABL. In triangle ABL. Here also BL square is equal to AL square plus AB square. BL square is equal to AL square plus AB square. Okay. Now, AL square can be written as AB by 2. AL can be written as AC by 2. That I'll make use of. BL square is equal to AL can be written as AC by 2. Whole square plus AB square. Fine, I'll continue. So BL square is equal to AC square by 4. AC square divided by 4 plus AB square. This is because of Pythagoras theorem. BL square is equal to, instead of AL, I can write AC by 2. AB square as it is, I am continuing here. So AC square by 4 plus AB square. Or I can write it as C. If I take a LCM, this, if I move it to this side, 4BL square is equal to, since 4 will be the LCM, this 4 LCM I transfer to the left hand side. What I can write now? AC square plus 4AB square. Since 4 was the LCM, so if nothing is there in the denominator, 1 will be there, 1 into 4, 4AB square. Okay, now, so 4BL square is equal to AC square plus AB square. So, yes, it is there. We call it as equation 2. Next, in triangle AMC, what we can write? We can write CM square is equal to, Or else similarly we will get right. The cm square is equal to right. Cm square is equal to am square plus ac square. Fine. So cm square I will write as it is. Am can be written as ab by 2. Ab by 2 whole square plus ac square. Similarly, we can write it as cm square divided is equal to ab square divided by 4 plus ac square. Or else we can write it as 4, if I transfer to the left hand side, 4 cm square is equal to ab square plus 4 ac square. Okay, we will call this as equation number 3. Now what we need, see, we need 4bl square, 4cm square, if I add, I will get it. So add equation number 2 and 3, equation 2 plus 3, what we will get, wait, move a little bit. Okay, now equation 2 plus equation 3, now where is equation 2? 4bl square plus 4cm square, which is there on the left hand side, is equal to ac square plus 4ab square. Fine. So plus ab square plus 4ac square. Ab square plus 4ac square. Okay. So if I take 4 common out, 4bl square plus cm square is equal to ac square plus 4ac square. 4 plus 1, 5 ac square. 4ab square plus ab square, 5 ac square. 5 ab square. Okay. So, 4bl square plus cm square is equal to, 5 is the common thing. So, 5 into ac square plus ab square. So instead of ac square plus ab square, what can I write from the equation number 1? Ac square plus ab square is equal to bc square. So same thing I am going to write, I am going to continue here. So 4 times bl square plus cm square is equal to 5 times bc square. This is from equation 1. Okay, this was supposed to be 2. So this two it. Please note this now. Fourteenth example. O is any point inside a rectangle ABCD. Inside a rectangle ABCD, prove that inside a rectangle ABCD, prove that OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. Okay, we'll do one thing. So we'll write down the given thing. So what is given to us? ABCD is a rectangle. Fine. Now angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C is equal to angle D will be equal to 90 degrees. Fine, because in rectangle opposite sides will be equal and all the angles will be equal to 90 degrees. So this is given. What is required for us to prove OB square is equal to OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square, right? Next, proof. In the proof, what we need to write? See. So, before we go to proof, see. When we talk about OB and OD, we need a triangle. So, we need to make a triangle so that we can apply a Pythagoras theorem. So, we will do one thing. Draw PQ parallel to BC through point O. Construction. So we need a triangle. That is the reason we are making, we are constructing this. So draw PQ parallel to BC. PQ parallel to BC through O. Through O. So this is PQ parallel to BC through O. Okay. Now proof. Okay. Now what can I write? PQ is perpendicular to AB and PQ is perpendicular to CD because PQ is parallel to BC and angle B is and angle C is equal to 90 degree. Since it is parallel, since it is perpendicular, so this will also be equal to 90 degree. So that is the reason, because angle B is equal to angle C is equal to 90 degree. Okay, since this is parallel, this line is parallel to this line, and even we show that this angle is equal to 90 degree. Obviously, this angle will be also equal to 90 degree. Because angles on the same side of a transversal will be equal to 180 degree. So 90 plus 90, that is 180 degree. So now what can I write? In triangle BPO, what can I write? I can write, since this is right angle, OB square is equal to BP square plus OP square. BP square plus OP square. Next, I will call it as equation number 1. Next, in triangle OCQ, what we can write? We can write OC square. OC square is equal to OQ square plus CQ square. Okay, we will call it as equation number 2. Next, in triangle ODQ. So what we can write? This is right angle, opposite to right angle, OD square will be there. OD, hypotenuse will be there. What we can write, if I apply a Pythagoras theorem, I can write OD square is equal to OQ square plus DQ square. Fine, we will call it as equation number 3. Next, which is one more triangle? Triangle APO. In triangle APO, what can I write? I can write, since this is right angle, AO square is equal to AP square plus OP square plus OP square. So I will call it as number equation number. So what I need, where is OD and where is OD? This plus this. So we will add the equation. So equation 1 and equation 3. I need OB and OD on the right hand side. We will add them. Let's see what happens. So equation 1 plus equation 3. What I can write? I can write OB square plus OD square is equal to OB square plus OD square is equal to OB square is equal to OB square plus OD square is equal to. So where is that? BP square plus OP square. BP square plus OP square. I can extend this. BP square plus OP square and OQ square plus BQ square plus OQ square plus DQ square. Fine. Now, what I need OA. OA on the right hand side. See, on the left hand side, we need OB square plus OD square, we got. But on the right hand side, we need OA square and OC square. Where is OA? OC square. Okay. For that, see. Where is OB? OB, OB, right. Where is BP? BP plus OP. Where is BP? BP, what I need, so to get OA square, see, if I want OA square here, what I need, AP square plus OP square, so where is, I have OP square, how to get AP square, already I have OP square here, I need AP square, so AP is equal to DQ, AP is equal to DQ. See, since PQ is parallel to BC, PQ is parallel to AD, and one of the angles is equal to 90 degree. These two are rectangles. ADQC, ADQP, and BCQP are the two rectangles. So what I can say, AP is equal to DQ. So what I can write, OB square plus OD square. So I need OP because I need OP square and AP square. I have OP square plus. Is there any DQ square? Yes, there is a DQ square. In place of DQ square, what can I write? AP square. Because APQD is a rectangle. AP is equal to QD. Because AP is equal to, later we will write it. Okay. Next. What I need? OC square. To get OC square, I need OQ square plus QC square. What I have OQ square. I'll take it out. And one more thing, what I need to write now is, I have QC square. For that, is there any BP square? Yes. So, instead of BP square, what I can write QC square. So, the reason why what I give is, AP is equal to DQ, AP is equal to DQ, and BP is equal to CQ. BP is equal to CQ. Why? Because AP, QD, and BP, QC are rectangles. AP, QD, and AP, QD, and BP, QC are rectangles. BPQC are rectangles. Hope you understood. Is it visible? So I need to move a little bit. So we'll move it, okay? Don't worry. Okay, you are able to see. Now, the reason I have given is AP is equal to DQ, BP is equal to CQ because AP, QD and BP, QC are two rectangles. That is the reason AP is equal to DQ, BP is equal to CQ. Now what I need C. So already we have OB square. OB square plus OD square is equal to OP square plus AP square is nothing but OP square plus AP square. Where is OP square plus AP square? OP square plus AP square. See, OP square plus AP square is nothing but OA square plus. Next. OQ square, OQ square plus QC square. Where is OQ square plus CQ square? That is OC square. So, this is from 1 and 2. From, so 2 and 4. from 2 and 4. Okay. So, this is a required proof. So, one thing we are able to understand, see, I need to see this construction is very important. After that, so formation of rectangle, that idea is very important to understand this particular solution. Okay. Please note this.